Hey, my fellow NHLers, it's your friend Ebbs and Flows. Happy Monday, fellas. So we're back with another episode this week. I do not have any packs for you. I'm really sorry. It's difficult when you're kind of a smaller YouTube guy. We started at the end of last year, so I don't really have any backing, you know, from like EASH or, you know, whoever gives these people all these packs, like Bacon and everybody like that, or Don't Be Sod. I just don't get packs like that, so I'm, you know, on the lower end of that spectrum here. I'm just showing you I'm very close to completing our Minnesota set, so I'll have that coming later this week. I am, you know, only like 4 or 5 golds away, which we will get. So today, though, I just have some highlights for you. I always love gameplay. Hopefully you guys do too. We have 2 games in store. Not a good start for us, as you can see that clapper. Great move, great look, great one T from Krug there. Playing this guy looks like a Philly fan, so I definitely want to beat him because, yeah, if you guys don't know, I'm a huge Pittsburgh fan. But we come right back here with a beautiful look to our trail guy and just pulls one up and claps one short side. So it's 1-1 again. Again, fellas, that Minnesota set I will have complete later this week. So I'll, you know, make a video completing that, and I should get some packs later this week. I can't resist too long, so I'll definitely open some more up if that's what you're looking for. You know, we'll have more packs rolling. All right, fellas, so at the end of the first period, 1-1, obviously still anybody's game, but we do need to pick it up here a little bit. I think we're out shooting him. I showed you the stats there. It's still a close game, but right here he gives me a bit of an angle and I just go forehand, backhand. In a lot of my videos, fellas, you're gonna see that. I mean, that's just, if you can get the angle and if you can protect the puck right, those goals are just gonna be there. A lot of people always try to float or cut inside, and that's gonna leave a little bit of an outside lane if you can get it. So always be on the lookout for that, and if you can't, make sure you start practicing it or trying to go for it, you know, just in like practice against the goalie, where you can just go one-on-one with the goalie. If you can get that little backhand, or forehand, it's going to help you out a lot. That's for sure. It's going to score you some goals and add a new dimension to your offense here. So, all right, boys, we had a couple goals go up on the screen while I was talking. This one's going to be wild. Good puck work, and then the puck, you know, good passes and things like that, and I think the goalie was just so out of position that the shot ended up behind him. It was a good save, but unfortunately bounced in. Pretty fortunate goal. So we had a couple goals roll in there as I'm talking over the replays. 4-1 at the end of the second period. We certainly came out firing, really on top of our game, I felt like. Let's take a look at the stats here. 7-14 in shots. We're doubling him up there, but he's smoking me in faceoffs, fellas. I'm not really used to that, tell you that. But he's got some good centers down the middle, that's for sure. Not that that's to blame. He might just be better at me than faceoffs. Who knows? So again here, fellas, coming in and Kucherov with the snipe short side. That's still happening. In 16, it was way, you know, more frequent, that is for sure. But in this game, I don't get those too often. I get a few every once in a while. But, you know, good, right there, good shot, good goal. Moving on, 5-1. A little user pick action. How about that? We're off to the races. I knew he was going to look up there. He's been trying to kind of work it around all game. I am in staggered defense, so sometimes those people are open up there. Those top 2 defensemen can work the puck around sometimes, but not too long. There, Steen just cuts it off and a nice breakaway goal. So 6-1. In the third period. Moving on, boys, only about 50 seconds left. Good move there in the neutral zone. Coming in, we're going to do a BS spin move, and somehow that puck ends up on Johansson's stick, and he just throws it far left and it goes in. So obviously at the end of the game, I'm just messing around. If it was a 1-1 game, I seriously doubt I'd be rolling with spin moves, you know, into the crease. So a lucky goal there, obviously. 25-14 in shots, 8-16 in faceoffs, beat me there. That's a good win. We'll check out his record after our 2 games, all right? And this guy's too. This game was a little more competitive, that is for sure, especially at the start, but we do get a good start. So 1-0 early. Kucherov coming in there, it looks like he just mistimed the poke check. He knew I was going to go backhand, I believe, and just mistimed it a bit. So a good goal, a bit of a fortunate goal. Us, we're rolling without the puck for whatever reason, and we turn the puck over and he goes backside for a nice goal, tying it up. Still in the first period, so 1-1 against this Bruins fan. This guy, you know, was sticking around, fellas. Good player. You know, again, we'll get into the records and things like that after the game, or after the games, I should say. But this guy would not go away easily, you know. So another, you know, backhand forehand, backhand there. Good move coming across the blue line there to get the defenseman out of position. And we get another goal. So 2-1 in the first period. And that is going to pretty much do it for the first as far as highlights go. So 2-1, you know, soft lead, but that's okay. At least we're in the lead. Like I said, fellas, we do have a few goals this game. So does he. It just seemed like no matter how high I got this guy or how many goals I put up, this guy would just not go quietly into the night. So 7-3 in shots. We're definitely outplaying him a bit, but we got to keep it rolling. So let's get into the second period. Right here, fellas, I am just going to get so dangled. Get worked. Get absolutely worked. What a play. I love that. You know, I dangle enough people to, and I usually don't get dangled enough to a point where I can appreciate getting dangled, if that makes any sense. Just get dangled on ebbs and flows. just a great goal by him. We do answer back, though, and take that one, you know, a one goal lead again shortly after. Good puck work and just a clapper from, I think, Krug. You know, the Bruin, or no, I'm sorry, it was Johansson, thought it was Krug up there, but, so, yeah, a goal lead, fellas, just, that dangle was filthy, if you want to go back and watch that. Moving on, good poke check there in the neutral zone, feeding it up to Zuccarello. Zuccarello's too fast, coming in just four, and that was just backhand forehand, fellas. Like I said, these angles to the goal, if they're going to give them to you and not challenge you with a poke check, take the shot, take the dangle attempt, and try to get a goal. It's an easy way to get a goal, and it's going to make them uneasy in the defensive zone, that's for sure. Right here, a bad turnover again by us. That seems to be, you know, happening a little more often. We're being too careless with the puck, you know, when we're up two or three goals. But a good goal, Okposo kind of jams it in there. A bit of an odd goal, but it does go in. So 4-3, not bad. Still have our lead, 15-9 in shots, 9-7 in faceoffs. Finally winning some faceoff battles, right? Time of possession is in our favor. We got to lock this guy up, though, because it seems like, you know, two goal lead doesn't matter. This guy's still going to fight, still going to put some in the net. And, you know, especially after that second goal he had where he just worked me with the dangle, I need to be on my game here. Right here, almost a turnover, thank gosh, because that could have been going the other way. And Suter just, actually might have been Shea Weber, pulls up, too much power for that goalie, and just claps it by. It actually was Suter. And beautiful goal, right? Just off the goalie's face mask and in. Just a bit of a lucky goal. Again, boys, the backhand shot. It's happening. I don't know if this guy's playing like a 1-3-1, so he only has one defender splitting two people down the wings, you know what I mean? Where it's giving me that angle. Usually, you know, in these last two games, I feel like I've scored like that a lot more than usual. So it ended up being 6-3, boys. That's a bit of a work. I mean, it was 4-3 at one point, so it was a good game up until the third period. First guy we played, 35-22, pretty good record. His team, however, was very good. As you can see, he's got one of the collectibles there. He's got a Malkin, a Voracek, Phil Kessel, Jarrod Pacioretty. His offense might up and down be better than mine. Maybe not. I don't know. I don't have 86s on my third line. Defense, I think, you know, also pretty similar. So pretty similar teams and a pretty fair game. Second game we played 66-81. So even though that guy was hanging around, his record isn't that great, but a good player nonetheless. Definitely challenged me and gave me quite the dangle there, as you saw. A pretty good team up and down again. A lot of 87s and 88s. That's all good. And the defense is pretty solid too. So pretty similar teams. I do have that one main Sittler, you know, in the middle. There's our record, fellas, 43-1. I mean, we have just been rolling, having a lot of fun with Hutt. That's going to do it for me, fellas. Please like and subscribe if you've been enjoying these videos. I'll definitely have packs out later this week, and we'll complete that Minnesota set for us. All right, fellas, as always, take care.